was back in 83 in Jerryberry. We gathered in the mess to have a drink. Pongo Ponsonby the Edge wore an aspirin as a badge and left his teeth for safety in the sink. I got up and sang a song from Merry England, and the general had a sentimental look. He insisted that my nose was a perfect English rose and said he'd like to press it in a book. Then he gave us that old favourite Colonel Bogey, to the words that every subaltern there knew. But he kept on stopping short, said he needed our support. Glass of port, sir. Well, I don't mind if I do. Then in 94, we had a birthday party. I had 20 gins to keep myself awake. I stood up on my chair to recite the maiden's prayer and fell backwards in the gravy by mistake. Then a chap who suffered violently from hiccups did a native dance and took off half his clothes. But he didn't look his best in his riding boots and vest with a serviette ring dangling from his nose. We finished up the day with Nellie Dean's off, and the general said, when bidding me adieu, though I fought in several wars, that my favorite song, what's yours? What's mine, sir? Well, I don't mind if I do. I remember in the mess at Rummy Tummy, we met one night and started off from scratch. Some befuddled young recruit poured some salt on his cheroot and tried to light his sausage with a match. Then Tiddly Thompson drank a quart of sherry, and shortly after had to leave the mess. He went home, his matron said, tucked his breeches into bed, and screwed himself inside his trouser breast. Then some fathead filled my boots up with champagne hot, and I walked home in my socks at 2:30. It was pouring down with rain, but I'd do the same again. Same again, sir. Well, I don't mind if I do. Who is this Phil Harris fellow? What's he got that I can't get straightened out?